The next we are going to discuss about factors determining working capital requirements. That is, working capital requirements depends upon various factors. That is, there are no set of rules or formula to determine the working capital needs of the business concerned. And the following are the major factors which are determining the working capital requirements in that. First one is nature of business. That is, working capital of the business concerned largely depend upon the nature of the business. And if the business concerned follow the rigid credit policy and a transport or and all sell goods only for a cash, and they can maintain a lesser amount of working capital, and a transport company maintains a lesser amount of working capital, while a constructions of company maintains a large amount of working capital. Next, second one is product cycle. That is, amount of working capital depends upon the length of the production cycle, and if the production cycle length is small and they need to maintain a lesser amount of working capital. That is, if it is not, they have to maintain the large amount of working capital. And the third one is business cycle. That is, the business fluctuation lead to cyclical and seasonal changes in the business conditions, and it will affect the requirement of the working capital. In the booming credit conditions, the working capital requirement is larger, and in the depression conditions, and the requirement of working capital will reduce, and better business results lead to increase the working capital requirement. And fourth one is production policy. That is, it is also one of the factors which affect the working capital requirement of the business concerned. And if the company maintains the continuous production policy, there is a need of regular working capital. If the production of the policy of the company depends upon the situation or conditions, and the working capital requirement will depend upon the conditions laid down by the company. And the fifth one is credit policy. That is, credit policy of sales and purchase also affect the working capital requirements of the business concerned, and if the company maintains a liberal credit policy to collect the payments from its customers, and they have to maintain the more working capital. That is, if the company pays the dues on the last date, it will create the cash maintenance in hand and bank. And the sixth one is growth and expansion. That is, during the growth and expansion of the business concern, the working capital requirement are higher, and because it needs some additional working capital and incur some extra expenses at the initial stages. And the seventh one is availability of raw materials. That is, a major part of the working capital requirements are largely depend upon the availability of the raw materials. And the raw materials are the basic component of the production process. And if the raw material is not readily available, it leads to production stoppage. So, the concern must maintain the adequate material for that purpose. They have to spend some amount of working capital for that. And the eighth one is earning capacity. That is, if the business concern consists of high level of earning capacity, they can generate a more working capital. That is, with the help of cash from operations, and the earning capacity is also one of the factors which determine the working capital requirement of the business concerned.